an award. Yeah. Do you know who's won yet?
Yes, we do, but we cannot tell you.
So I know who's won. Yeah.
But open secrets are open. Yeah.
Look, say we're running this after they've won.
Yeah.
What's your opinion on that particular song that we're not spilling the beans on?
Fabulous. I think I do a great job in releasing songs like and it really defines the year, you know, the festivals and everything that you hear of everyone singing these songs. So I think you really deserve it.
Well done. Well done.
That was very good. Self-censoring.
Yeah, thank you. I'm trying.
So, what, I mean, like, you've been at QAwards, you've won QAwards. Do you remember the first time you were in the magazine with a photo on the cover?
Yeah, I think we've only had one cover, and that was for their, was it 25th anniversary or something like that? So, you know, it was me, Rihanna.
Yeah. A bunch of no names.
A bunch of no names, yeah. But I do remember the very first art school we got in Q, and it was like an introducing piece. I think we were photographed spitting beer everywhere. As you can see, that's not how you conduct yourself. But it was just, I've read Q for years, we all have, and it was only ever serious bands and real bands that get covered in Q. And there's that moment in any band's career or artist's career when Q covers you, you feel that you've kind of, well, we're in with the big boys there, and that's what it felt like, so we'll always be appreciative of that.
We've just seen Ed Sheeran walk down the red carpet with two broken arms. Dave Grohl had to cancel two dates because he broke his leg. Yep. Bono broke his back. What's the worst injury you've ever soldiered through to go on stage?
I've broken my foot and then had to shoot a music video the next day. We played a show in Glasgow, I jumped off a 20-foot PA, snapped my foot, straight to the hospital, straight down to London to shoot a video. The video's questions and answers, I'm in a wheelchair. And and yeah, I've broken ribs and teeth and everything. I'm incredibly clumsy when
just
it comes to
rolling.
I think so. I don't know if it's like, it's probably a kind of subconscious thing I have where I like to feel like I'm pushing myself to the edge, and then inevitably some nights you go too far and you feel like a fool. But yeah, it has to be, feel like it's close to the edge, like that something's going to happen. That's what makes a good show.
That's got, at least it's more rock and roll than getting knocked off a bike.
Yeah, exactly. Yeah. We'll tell you that.
Yeah.
Oh, no.
And the other thing that we learned on the red carpet, Mickey Wire was telling me that he doesn't think there's going to be another Manic album. He says he hasn't written anything for years. He stopped listening to music. He just can't get the inspiration. Well, I mean, that's a huge loss, right?
It is, so unless he becomes the head of Plaid Cymru, which I can see happening, because he's incredibly eloquent when he speaks about politics. But that's disappointing to me. You know, I don't see a point where we'll ever stop making records. You know, it's, to me, that's what the artistic statement is. You know, to me, a song is a bit more fleeting and things, and that's, yeah, it's disappointing. Hopefully, I'll try and change his mind tonight. Nicky, I've got a bone to pick. But no, you can understand it, though. You know, you can understand it.
I think there are periods as well. I mean, you must have had them where you just can't write, where you can't envisage something to write about.
I think that's it. You know, you feel that it's a real drought at certain points. You think maybe you've written your best songs, or that, you know, someone else is doing some kind of music. You're like, oh, why didn't I think of that? But that comes and goes, you know. And I think it's in Nicky's bones as well. I don't see him actually being able to give up. You know, he might not have written a song for a while, but now that he's said that, he's probably going to write 100 songs.
Well, then you take a little break before Ellipsis, and then number one album.
Yeah, I know it will. Nicky. Work for
that. The other thing, like Liam Gallagher last week going, I've got a number one album, rock and roll is back. I was going, I'm pretty sure Biffy did
it
last
year. Yeah, there have been a few, yeah. Maybe not been quite paying attention, but thank you for including us in that. Appreciate it.
And what do you think, like, he sold more records on vinyl than anybody else did in the rest of the top 10. He could have been number one on that alone.
Is that right?
Yeah.
I think it's amazing, and it just goes to show that people do still want a piece of art, something that they can hold, and something that is a statement. You know, from someone like Liam Gallagher, it's like we've all been waiting for a statement from him for a while, and this record is it. So it really gives me a lot of hope that if you put the work in and do good art, you know, good art, good artwork with the records, and then I think people will be interested, and that's what it's all about. Don't be lazy.
Yeah. And speaking of which, what are you working on right now?
We are always working on new music. We've got a couple of cool projects coming up that we'll be able to talk about soon. But yeah, just working on new music all the time and see what those seeds sprout.
That's great. Oh, thanks very much for stopping us up.
Pleasure. Thank you. Thank you. Have a good day.
Have a good night.
Take care.
Cheers.
Bye.
Hello, guys. We'll do some more online media.
Hello.
Hello.
How are we all doing?
Hello.
I'm looking forward to seeing everybody. I think it's the people that you weren't expecting. The people that you weren't expecting to like are the ones that often, you know, throw the most surprises. So it's an inclusive atmosphere. So we're looking forward to seeing everyone.
That is fantastic. That, there you go.
Are you
fans of Liam Gallagher?
Yeah, he's an icon. Guys, how are you going to follow up Ellipsis?
With another album?
Yeah. Even bigger and better.
Is it like more of the same?
Never.
No.
That's what we try and not do that every time. Like, if we feel like we're doing something that's a bit too similar to before, we scrap it. Yeah. And you know, like, that's the whole point of being a band and making music, is to kind of try and grow and evolve. And if you're doing the same thing all the time, then it becomes a job. And this is not, this band isn't a job for us.
Could you make a puzzle number two? I liked.
Yeah, maybe puzzle the sequel. Yeah. We just do the same thing, but all the songs will be backwards. Why not?
What are like your influences for your new music?
Oh, lots. I mean, I guess there's a lot of trap music that it's still, I've been listening to a lot of that the last few years, and so the next record will be a trap record. No, there's a lot of interesting production coming out of some of these records, like 21 Savage and things, some of these mumbly rappers that the production on it's so weird. So I think it feels like all rules have gone out the window. The new King Krule record's beautiful, it's really bizarre. I don't know how he writes his songs. So things like that are really kind of intriguing me at the moment, just things that throw structure out the window and kind of just take a new approach to songwriting.
Any like interesting collaboration shit coming up? Like, who are you going to work with?
James is doing a reggae record with Tom Jones.
Don't tell anybody, please.
No, I mean, we've got a couple of exciting things coming up. I can't say anything just yet, but no, these are my collaborators right here, and hopefully I will remain their collaborator.
Oh, that's sweet.